Hi, this is Pattu from FreeFinCal. On this video, let's review Mirae Asset Tax Saver Fund. If you're looking for an ELSS fund that's far removed from the crowd or where the most people invest, this could be a choice for you. So basic information about the fund. The fund was launched in December 2015. The fund manager is Nilesh Surana. Surana also manages the other popular funds from Mirae, Mirae Emerging and Mirae India Equity. He also manages Mirae Hybrid Fund, which I had recently reviewed. The AUM is about 1,100 crores. Sorry about the typo there. The expense ratio of the direct plan is an awesome 0.36%. That is awesome. I was astonished to see that. The investment strategy is to look for growth stocks across market cap. It's more or less similar to emerging blue chip and India equity fund. It could be a mix of that, and I think you can expect stocks of all across market cap in this tax saver fund. So this will hold 80% equity, like all tax saver funds have to do. So the reason why I looked at this fund was, I was looking at the value research ELSS fund list. I noticed that the Axis long-term equity has an AUM of 16,000 crores. That's atrociously, high compared to the other funds. Of course, the Mirae Tax Saver is like a poor 13th in terms of AUM, in that's just 1,133 or so. But most people seem to be preferring Axis long term, probably because the Axis Bank is pushing it, the distributors are pushing it, whatever the reasons. But I think it makes no sense for if you're a new investor looking for a ELSS fund, then for the first time, then it makes no sense for you to put it in such a popular fund. I mean, it's too high. Too many people are rushing towards there. If you like an offbeat choice away from the maddening crowd, then Mirae Tax Saver can be an option for you, as I'll discuss in the coming slides. I hold a list called Plumbline. This is my list of handpicked mutual funds. In that list, that was last updated in September. There's no change, but the next one will be in December. In that list, I recommend Franklin Tax Shield. That is also a less popular choice, but it's quite consistent and it's also low volatile. So if you're a first time investor, that could also be an option for you. So before we look at the Mirae fund, do you actually need an ELSS fund? Rather, does your portfolio need it? I mean, that's more important, right? So I would suggest that for long-term goals which are more than 10 years away, you have not more than 60% of equity, and 40% should be your fixed income. Your fixed income can be your EPF. It can be your VPF that you actually invest on your own in the EPF. It can be PPF. It can be NPS without any equity. So if you are able to reach 1.5 lakh, that ATC limit, just by investing 40% of your, of the money that you can invest every month or every year in fixed income, then in EPF, PPF, etc., then you do not need an ELSS fund. So if 40% of your investments, if you can cover that 1.5 lakh just in fixed income investments like EPF and PPF, you do not need an ELSS fund. So, but what happens is, for many young earners, if they invest 1.5 lakh in EPF or PPF, then the fixed income asset allocation will become higher than 40%. But in my opinion, that's okay. Let it be high for the first few years. As long as your income will increase and later on you can invest more in equity, non-ELSS funds, I think there's no need for an ELSS fund still. Only when in situations where when the 1.5 lakh in fixed income would mean above 60% of weight in the portfolio. That is, suppose if you put 1.5 lakh in EPF or PPF, then the fixed income allocation becomes 70% or 80%. Then I think you need an ELSS fund to balance it out a little bit. Other than that, if you can manage 40% in fixed income from the 1.5 lakh alone, or if it just increases for that 40% limit, then do not buy the ELSS fund. Just invest in EPF and PPF. The reason is, ELSS funds are kind of painful because each SIP or each investment will be locked for 3 years. Then it's painful for you to pull it out and so on. And whatever you do, do not invest in ELSS funds if you do not need the tax saving. That's very important. So, and also, even if you need the ELSS fund, try to, instead of an SIP, you can invest like 4 times or 5 times a year manually from time to time. Anyways, it's just the same. So that may be slightly easier for you to manage it down the line in terms of lock-in period of the units. So again, I'll tell you, this review is only meant for those who are looking for a new ELSS fund. If you already hold ELSS funds, do not buy another. That's just silly. So I'm. This is the since inception comparison of Mirae Asset Tax Saver versus Axis Long Term Equity. Since inception, it has it seems to have bet the Axis Long Term Equity quite fine. There are some instances where the volatility of the Mirae Asset is slightly higher than the Axis Long Term Equity. But I mean, if you are okay as an investor with that, it's fine. And these are the 2-year rolling return comparison. So every data point in the blue curve and the red curve is a 2-year data point, 2-year return data point. So the Mirae Asset Fund seems to have bet the Axis Long Term Equity. Of course, the history is small, so you cannot say Mirae Asset is better than Axis Long Term Equity. At least you can say that Mirae Asset is not worse than Axis Long Term Equity from these graphs. I also have a tool called the fingerprinting tool. All the links for these tools are you can find in the description box. So in this fingerprinting tool, what you can do is you compare monthly returns of the fund with respect to the benchmark, which is Nifty 200 Total Returns Index for both Mirae Asset and Axis Long Term Equity. So you compare monthly returns and you divide the performance into 4 sections. So in this pink section, fund underperforms the market. In this blue section, fund outperforms the market when the market is going up and underperforms when the market is going down. So you don't want to be in the pink or the blue. The green is fund outperforms the market. The light green here is, or the gray is, fund outperforms the market when the market is down and underperforms when the market is going up. So this is fine. I think most of the data points are in the outperformance region. There is some underperformance in terms of monthly returns, but that's expected for every fund. In fact, if you look at the Axis long-term equity also, there is such a similar data. Now, what I have done is I have compared the fingerprint in the next slide. I have compared Mirae Asset Tax Saver versus Axis long-term equity. And in this graph, outperformance means Mirae Asset outperforming Axis fund. Underperformance means Mirae Asset underperforming Axis fund. So you can see that typically for more months, the Mirae Asset fund has outperformed the Axis long-term equity. So it's even though it has got a short history, in that short history, it has done quite well. Sometimes you need to make such offbeat choices when you choose mutual funds. You know, you need to go with your gut instinct and say, okay, this looks fine. I'm just going to go with it. You can't always demand for long-term performance, long-term consistency and so on. Sometimes you just need to go with your gut. So if you do not mind an offbeat choice with a short history, you can choose Mirae Asset, in my opinion. If you want an offbeat choice with history and volatility, Franklin Tax Shield is a very good option. And if your this is only if your portfolio, not you, if your portfolio needs an ELSS fund. If your portfolio does not need an ELSS fund, do not choose ELSS fund. There's a big mistake. Many people compare ELSS with PPF and EPF. That's a stupidity. For people with the right asset allocation in mind, 60% equity and 40% fixed income, it doesn't matter where that 1.5 lakh comes from. That 1.5 lakh ATC tax saving can come entirely from fixed income. It can come entirely from equity as well. That is also fine. It doesn't matter. But my point is, look at your tax, look at your asset allocation, and already you will be having PPF, most of you will be having EPF. Then why not use that itself to invest in for ATC? There's no need for a ELSS fund where you're locking every unit for 3 years and so on. So that's the reason why I'm saying you don't need an ELSS fund, and it is wrong to compare ELSS with PPF. So let me know in the comment section if you will choose this Mirae fund. Let me know what other funds you would like reviewed. I'm at FreeFinCal on Twitter. You can follow me there. And also, if you like the videos, share them and do subscribe to this channel and press the notification buttons for updates. So I'll catch you again in another video. Bye-bye.